Now, let us apply the theorem that we learned in the previous video by answering this example. In triangle RST not shown, the measure of angle R is 45 and the measure of angle S is 64. Let's find the measure of angle T. So in this particular example, even though we don't have the figure, we have already our given, which are the two angles with known measures, and what we are to find is the measure of the third angle, which in this case the measure of angle T. So by using and by applying the theorem that we had, we know that the interior angles of a triangle are equal to 180, or their sum is equal to 180. So therefore we can say that the measure of angle R plus the measure of angle S plus the measure of angle T is equal to 180. Okay? And by substitution, we know that the measure of angle R is 45 plus the measure of angle S is 64 plus, this is what we are looking for, the measure of angle T is equal to 180. Okay? And to simplify the left side, we have here 45 plus 64 is 109 plus the measure of angle T is equal to 180. And then subtracting both sides of the equation by 109, then we say that the measure of angle T is 71. Okay? To check if our answer is correct, we say that the measure of angle R plus the measure of angle S plus the measure of angle T is equal to 180. By substitution again, the measure of angle R is 45 plus the measure of angle S is 64 and plus the measure of angle T that we obtained is 71. Will that be equal to 180? So 45 plus 64 plus 71 is 180, and it's equal to 180, and our answer is correct. Okay, now let's have a corollary. A corollary is actually a post theorem. Okay, this is an extension of a theorem. Okay. So, like theorems, of course, they have to be proved first before they can be used. So, it says here that each angle of an equiangular triangle measures 60 degrees. We know that in the definition that we presented in the previous video that an equiangular triangle has three congruent acute angles. So, in that case, let's try to prove this. Okay, so let's have first our given. I'm going to write it here. So given is we have triangle ABC is an equiangular triangle. Equiangular triangle. Okay. Let's prove that the measure of angle A is 60, the measure of angle B is 60, and the measure of angle C is also 60. Okay, let's have our proof. I don't have enough space. So these are statements and these are our reasons. Okay, so number one, again, we know that triangle ABC is an equiangular triangle, and of course that is given. And since triangle ABC is an equiangular angle, we know that angle A is congruent to angle B and it's also congruent to angle C. that is definition of an equiangular triangle. Equiangular triangle. Okay, and then we already know that the measure of angle A is equal to the measure of angle B is also equal to the measure of angle C. And that is definition of congruent angles. Now, in the previous discussion, we have learned that the measure of angle A plus the measure of angle B plus the measure of angle C, the measure of angle C is equal to 180, okay? And because the sum of the interior angles of a triangle is 180 degrees, okay? Now let's continue it here. These are our statements and these are our reasons. So according to statement number 4 and statement number 3, we can just substitute, okay, since they are all equal. So number 5, the measure of angle A plus the measure of angle A plus the measure of angle A is equal to 180. We can also say that the measure of angle B plus the measure of angle B plus the measure of angle B is equal to 180, as well as the measure of angle C plus the measure of angle C plus the measure of angle C is also equal to 80. And the reason is substitution. Okay? Substitution. Okay? Now, so we can say that this is actually 3 times the measure of angle A is equal to 180. We also have 3 times the measure of angle B is also equal to 180. And 3 times the measure of angle C, which is also equal to 180. And that is actually distributive. Okay? Distributive property. And, of course, we can divide the both sides of the equation by 3. So that this gives us, or therefore, we can say now that the measure of angle A is equal to 60, the measure of angle B is equal to 60, and the measure of angle C is also equal to 60 by, sorry, 67. By, the reason is the division property of equality. And we are done. Okay, we have already shown that each angle of an equiangular triangle measures 60 degrees. Okay, next, the acute angles of a right triangle are complementary. Okay, I'm not going to show to you a direct proof of this, but I will just be showing to you how we show that this corollary holds or is true. Okay, so let's say that given that we have triangle ABC is a right triangle, and since it's a right triangle, angle B, okay, is a right angle. Let's prove that. I'm going to show that angle A and angle C, which are acute angles, are complementary. We need to say that their sum would be equal to 90. Okay. Now, so actually this is a way of showing you how to provide proofs of corollaries and theorems in paragraph form. So, I'll just be introducing it to you. Since angle B is a right angle, okay, then we say that then, okay, the measure of angle B is equal to 90, okay? And we know that the measure of angle A plus the measure of angle B plus the measure of angle C is equal to 90 as well. 180 rather. Equal to 180. Okay? So, this implies that, okay, this implies that the measure of angle A plus 90 plus the measure of angle C is equal to 180, which implies that if we subtract both sides of the equation by 90, then the measure of angle A plus the measure of angle C is equal to 90. Okay? And we have already shown that angle A and angle C are complementary, because we can say here that the measure of angle A is equal to 90 minus the measure of angle C, as well as the measure of angle C is equal to 90 minus the measure of angle A. Okay? And this is done. Okay. Also, I'm not going to show to you the proof of this anymore because we are running out of time. If two angles of one triangle are congruent to two angles of another triangle, then the third angles are also congruent. So if we are to draw, anyways, I will be showing to you the proof of this in chapter 3. I will just show to you this corollary. Okay, so let's say we have triangle ABC and triangle RTU. Okay, according to that corollary, if angle A is congruent to angle R, angle B is congruent to angle T. Have to take note of the correct correspondence. Then we can say that angle C is congruent to angle U. Okay, and that is by the law of detachment. Okay. The law of detachment has been discussed to you in chapter 1. So, you see here that we have angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, angle 4, angle 5 and angle 6 are all exterior angles. Okay? Exterior angles. Because when the sides of a triangle are extended, okay, each angle that is formed by a side and an extension of the adjacent side is what we call the exterior angle. So what I'm saying is, if we are to extend one side here, this side here, this side here, then the angles formed with those extensions are called exterior angles, okay? So if we have this triangle, let's say in triangle ABC, we extend, okay, extend line BC. such that it will pass through point D. Okay? And if that's the case, we see that angle ACD is an exterior angle. Okay? Exterior angle. And you can see that angle A and angle B are actually remote. Okay? Remote interior angles. Okay? They are remote interior angles. So again, angle ACD is the exterior angle, and angles A and B are the remote interior angles. Let's have a corollary. The measure of an exterior angle, okay, of a triangle equals the sum of the measures of the two non-adjacent interior angles, or we call it actually the remote. These are actually remote interior angles. Okay? So I'm not going to show to you the proof of this because I'm going to prove this to you in your modern geometry class. Should I be your teacher? Okay? So let's have first an illustration. Let's draw a triangle. Okay. Let's name this one as P. Let's name this one as A. Let's name this one as R, and let's name this one as point T. Okay? So in triangle rod RAT, we say that angle PAT is the exterior angles. Again, I am just recalling to you the names, or how we are going to identify the parts of the triangle. The PAT is the exterior angle, and angle T and angle R are the remote, okay? The remote interior angles. Okay? According to the corollary, if that's the case, then the measure of angle PAT is equal to the measure of angle T plus the measure of angle R. Okay? Let's have an example. Given that we have in the figure, the measure of angle 1 is x squared plus 2x. The measure of angle S is x squared minus 2x. And the measure of angle T is equal to 3x plus 10. We can say here that angle VRS or angle SRV is the exterior angle. And angle S and angle T are the remote interior angles. But we can say that angle SRV is also angle 1. So the relationship is that we can say that, let's first write the relationship. The measure of angle 1 is equal to the measure of angle S plus the measure of angle T. And by substitution, we see that the measure of angle 1 is x squared plus 2x. We have x squared plus 2x. is equal to the measure of angle S is x squared minus 2x. We have x squared minus 2x plus the measure of angle B is 3x plus 10. This is 3x plus 10. And then removing the grouping symbol to simplify our equation, we have x squared plus 2x is equal to x squared minus 2x plus 3x plus 10. And then we know that we can cancel out x squared, subtracting both sides of the equation by x squared. This becomes 0. Okay, and what we have here is subtracting both sides by x, because 2x, let's simplify this one, let's simplify this. This is already positive x, so that what we have here is 2x, I'm sorry, I'm going to use red. This is 2x, okay, minus x, subtracting both sides by x, is equal to 10. And therefore, we know that x is equal to 10. Okay? To check whether our value of x is correct, we need to show that the measure of angle 1 is equal to the measure of angle S plus the measure of angle T. Okay? By substitution, the measure of angle 1 is equal to x squared plus 2x. And the value of x is 10. So that would be 10 squared plus 2 times 10 is equal to 120. Okay? And then, the measure of angle S is equal to x squared minus 2x. And that's 10 squared minus 2 times 10, which is equal to 80. And the measure of angle T is 3x plus 10, which is 3 times 10 plus 10, which is equal to 40. Okay? So that, so we can say that the measure of angle 1 is equal to rather. The measure of angle 1 is equal to the measure of angle S plus the measure of angle T. So by substitution, this is 120, will that be equal to 80 plus 40? We know that 120 is equal to 120. And our answer is correct. Okay?